Hey guys, in this video, we're going to talk about the amazing neutrophil. Now, what is a neutrophil? Neutrophil is a type of white blood cell, and the white blood cells are part of the immune system. But the interesting thing about the neutrophil, it's your primary defense against bacteria, fungus, candida, and some viruses. It's kind of like your army or your police force that goes in there that protects you. So if you want to protect yourself against infection and other types of lowered immune system, you really need to understand more about this system because there's some unique things about it. So it's a specialized type of white blood cell. And when you have an infection or an injury, the majority of the white blood cell is the neutrophil. So let's just talk about what it is. It's a type of phagocyte. It's a cell, and that means the cell that eats things up. So it consumes bacteria. And if you ever see a little video of it, you'll see that the cell just kind of goes around and just like Pac-Man, just eats it right up. And that would be probably the best analogy. It's your Pac-Man of your body. So it also releases very powerful enzymes to break down proteins because these bacteria are made out of protein. So it releases proteases, there's an enzyme, cytokines, and other things that are involved in the immune process that actually help destroy. So you can look at it like the neutrophils have Claymore mines, they have M16s, they have light anti-tank weaponry, they have shotguns, they have all this weaponry to deal with these microbes. And so that's the good news, right? There's some bad news. We'll get to that. So they're involved in infection and injury. And the interesting thing about it is that if there is refined carbohydrates in the diet, if there is sugar in the diet, fructose especially, what will happen is these neutrophils will go after that sugar and leave the infection alone. Okay, so they kind of are inactivated, neutralized with sugar or glucose. So I've noticed when people do a lot of sugar, their sinuses get congested or they might have more mucus buildup. And a lot of times people get sick after they eat sugar as well. And that's probably why, because it's a bit of an inactivation of the neutrophil. The other thing is, there's a study, and I'm going to put this below, and I'll put the sugar study down below. The motion of grief apparently suppresses the neutrophil. So there's a study done that shows that when people go through losses or grief, it really suppresses this white blood cell, making the person very susceptible to infection and autoimmune. So, I mean, over the last 27 years, almost every single autoimmune case occurred after some type of loss, a loss of a loved one, divorce, you know, when they were grieving, because you really set your immune system up for opening the door for all sorts of the microbes and viruses kind of invading the body. Also, neutrophils in high amounts are found in autoimmune diseases, like rheumatoid arthritis. It's in the joint of rheumatoid arthritis patients. So what does that mean? It means that these things can go rogue and they lose their ability to differentiate between a microbe and your own tissue. And that's an autoimmune case. So rheumatoid arthritis is an autoimmune case. So you have these, your own immune system attacking itself. So you have a lot of neutrophils going on in that situation. So vitamin C is the remedy for most people. So vitamin C happens to be a real good antihistamine, natural antihistamine. It's a good thing to speed up the activation of neutrophils. The neutrophils even have receptors for vitamin C. And when there's an infection or an injury, they dump up to 100 times, not 100%, 100 times more vitamin C into the cascade, into the infection than they normally would. Leaving the blood, actually, a lot of times when you check the blood, an infection, it goes way down with vitamin C. That's because the neutrophils in the white blood cells are pulling it, and it's needing it to put into this whole immune reaction. So what does that mean? It means that if you're low in vitamin C, you're not going to be able to fight these infections that well. And that's probably why the adrenal glands have a huge storage of vitamin C ready for this reaction to infections. The other thing is cortisol in general. Cortisol is the adrenal hormone. They basically treat autoimmune cases with cortisol. because cortisol tends to suppress the white blood cell, but not necessarily the neutrophil. It actually will increase the neutrophil, which is very interesting. So they don't really know why it does that, but I think the reason why is it has a temporary boost of immune support, if it's temporary. But then what happens over a long period of time when cortisol decreases or the person burns out, when they have low cortisol, like in a condition called Addison's, their immune system is very, very fragile and weak. They're always getting sick. They get autoimmune type situations. So what happens is low cortisol puts the person at risk too. So we need cortisol in the right amounts. So it just goes to show you that if you're stressed out, burnt out, on sugar, nutritionally deprived of vitamin C, you're setting yourself up to have more infections and more arthritis and more inflammation. As far as vitamin C goes, yes, there are synthetic versions of vitamin C and there's some natural versions. Now, if you're going to take vitamin C, and I'm not opposed to you taking a short-term synthetic version, if it's something like calcium ascorbate, which is a buffered ascorbic vitamin C, as long as you take it with bioflavonoids, because you need the whole complex. Because if you take straight ascorbic acid, or even one portion of the vitamin C out of the complex, you can end up being deficient in the other factors. So make sure it comes with a complex, the rutin, the bioflavonoids, and as many additional things as possible. Lemons, limes are awesome. It's really, really important to do a lot of that. So that's one thing you can do. Number two is to avoid the sugar. But the other thing too is you can get these lymphocytes to work faster by acidifying them through the apple cider vinegar. There's some really cool studies that show that when you acidify the body, the phagocytes go to work and they clean up the infections a lot faster. There's even a book. I'll have to try to find it. If I find it, I'll put a link down below. It's talking about using hydrochloric acid. They used to inject people with diluted hydrochloric acid back in, I think, the 40s. And they found they can actually get rid of an infection really, really fast. So that was hydrochloric acid. But you can use other acids too, like apple cider vinegar, and actually drink it in a glass of water with a straw. But that will help as well. But the neutrophil is your primary defense mechanism. I think it's good to understand what to do and to protect yourself by supporting these guys. And I just want to give you little insights on what you can do if you actually find that you're susceptible, you're running down. These are some actions that you need to think about. All right, thanks for watching.